बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम।
डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास ओ टू, अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू द न्यू सेशन विच आई होप इज गोइंग टू गिव अ न्यू होराइजन टू योर इंग्लिश लर्निंग। दिस इज सबीहा इमरान, योर न्यू इंग्लिश टीचर। आई हैव माई एजुकेशनल बैकग्राउंड इन इंग्लिश लिटरेचर एंड आई एम अ सर्टिफाइड टीचर। द 23 ईयर्स टीचिंग एक्सपीरियंस हैज गिवन मी कॉन्फिडेंस टू अश्योर यू दैट विद मी यू विल लर्न अ ग्रेट डील। Like every year, I have set my goals for my students this year as well, and these goals are in collaboration with the objectives of CAIE syllabus. Let's have a look at the goals. My goals are, for the new session are not only to develop subject knowledge but also skills, and to encourage the learners to be, number one, confident in working with information and ideas, their own and those of others. Number two, responsible for themselves and responsive to and respectful of others. Number three, reflective as learners, developing their own ability to learn. Number four, innovative and equipped for new and future challenges. Number five, engaged intellectually and socially, ready to make a difference. Now let's have a look at the syllabus of English we are going to practice this session. You can see the syllabus here. Under the heading of writing, we have to do directed writing and creative writing. Okay, in directed writing, we have speech writing, article writing, letter writing, account writing, and report writing. And compositional work or the creative writing, we are going to include narrative writing, descriptive writing, and argumentative writing. Okay, and as far as reading is concerned, so we are going to just practice two types of passages. Comprehension passage one will be for meaning, and the other passage there will be some passages for ideas as well. Along with this, we are going to practice as to how we can summarize the given passages. And as far as grammar is concerned, so you can see there is a whole long list here. We are going to revise tenses and subject verb agreement, active passive voice, direct indirect speech, conditional sentences will be there as well, and parts of speech, modal verbs, verbals and participles, phrases and clauses, transitional words and rhetorical devices, figures of speech and punctuation. And if we just talk about the vocabulary, so we have to improve our vocabulary a great deal so that we could use a variety of sentence structures and variety of words in our composition. And for that purpose, we have to just practice theme-based vocabulary, precise vocabulary, phrasal verbs, and idioms. So now it's time to have a look at the paper pattern for English 1123. This 1123 is the syllabus code for the paper that you are going to attempt. Well, your English language 1123 paper comprises two parts or two papers. Paper 1 is writing and paper 2 is reading. Paper 1 writing itself has two sections. In section number 1, you will find one topic for directed writing. You are advised to write between 200 and 300 words here, and total marks for this section will be 30. You will be awarded up to 15 marks for following the task instructions, and you will be awarded up to 15 marks for the language you use. Only one task out of the following will be given, so you have no options to choose from. Like there can be a topic on speech or article or letter writing, account writing, or it can be on report writing. And if we talk about section 2 of paper 1, so it is on composition or creative writing, and you have to write on any one of the tasks which are given to you. There will be 5 topics or 5 tasks, and you have to choose any one out of them. You are advised to write between 350 and 500 words. Total marks for this section will be 30. And the 5 tasks that will be given to you will be based on descriptive writing, argumentative writing, or narrative writing. Well, paper 2 of English language 1123 is on reading. It itself has 2 sections. In section number 1, you will find a passage in the insert and you have to read this passage for ideas. The passage will be fact based, like an article or a report, and there will be 2 questions. One question, or the question number 1, will be notes taking and it will be of 12 marks. And students have to identify and write down the information as content points from the passage, which describes either advantages or disadvantages, similarities and differences, problems and solutions, etc. And students are supposed to use material from the whole passage. You will be awarded up to 12 marks for the content points. Well, B part of question number 1 will be summary writing and you will be awarded 10 marks for it. Okay, and you are expected to use your own words as far as possible. You will be awarded marks for producing a piece of writing which is relevant, well organized and easy to follow. Your summary must be in continuous writing, not in note form. You are advised to write between 150 and 180 words, including the 10 given words. Okay. And question number 2 of section 1, reading for ideas, will be of 3 marks. And in this question, you will be asked to identify and write down 3 opinions from the given paragraphs. Well, if we talk about section 2 of paper 2, which is on reading, then this time another passage will be given to you and this time you will read the passage for meaning. And here you will be awarded 25 marks. Candidates read a narrative passage which will be of approximately 700 words, and then they are expected to write short answers to the questions, which will be almost seven in number. And here your ability to understand the language for both explicit and implicit meaning is being checked. Okay, and here you will be awarded 16 marks. And if you move down to question number 8, so you will find that this question is based on vocabulary. And students will be given some words from the passage, and options will be given, 4 options will be given to select the closest meaning to that word. Here, you will be given 5 marks. And question number 9 will be about the effect and meaning of the statements which will be given from the passage. And here you will get 4 marks. Dear students, I expect you all will put your best foot forward at all times during this session towards learning. Whatever task will be given to you, you are expected to do it wholeheartedly. Maintain a good record of your work in your notebooks. Your zeal and cooperation will make learning a hilarious and exciting experience. Saying goodbye for now, see you soon. Allah Hafiz.